As a medical coder, everyone needs to understand the latest changes in the ICD-10-CM, CPT and HCPCS. As all of us know, we have started 2024 ICD-10-CM course, which we have started using from October 1st, 2023. Now it's our turn to learn CPT 2024 updates, which we are going to use from January 1st, 2024. So my name is Harish, medical coder, process trainer, content creator for FastCoder 21 free medical coding YouTube channel. In my channel, you will get all the topics related to inpatient, outpatient, denial management, anesthesia coding, pathology, radiation oncology, and few specialty topics. And also, we are going to know free AAPC webinar information, which we need to use in order to fulfill AAPC's 36 free CU webinar criteria. And also, you are going to know latest jobs for medical coders. So in this session, we are going to know 2024 CPT updates. So in this session, we are going to know only changes related to surgery section. Means we are going to learn 10,000 to 60,000 series. So what is new in 2024? So in 2024, we have 349 changes. So basically these changes, additions, deletions are complete. Means total CPT book is having 349 changes irrespective of the sections and 230 additions, 49 deletions, 70 revisions, and total we are having 11,163 CPT codes currently in 2024 book. So the secret behind CPT surgery coding is you need to know the code descriptions of each and every CPT code, and you need to know the medical necessity for each and every CPT code. If you want to become master in CPT coding, you need to know these two criteria. Now we will see chapter wise additions, revisions and deletions. So if you take evaluation management, we have one addition and 10 revisions. And if you take anesthesia, there are no additions, revisions and deletions. So don't worry, I will create one session only for evaluation management in future. And also in integumentary system, we don't have any addition, revision and deletion. And musculoskeletal system, we have 4 additions and 6 revisions and there are no deletions. In respiratory system, we have 2 additions, there are no revision and deletion. In cardiovascular system, we have 8 additions and there are no revisions and deletions. In digestive system, there are no additions, revisions and deletions. Urinary system, we have only 1 addition and there are no revisions and deletions. In male genital system, we don't have any additions, revisions and deletions. But in female genital system, we have 1 addition, so there are no revisions or deletions. In nervous system, we have 6 additions, 4 revisions and there are no deletions. And eye and ocular adnexa, we have only 1 addition and there are no revision or deletions. In auditory system, there are no addition, revision and deletion. In radiology, we have 5 additions and 1 deletion. In pathology and laboratory, 75 additions, revisions 25 and deletions 15. So if you are planning to write CPC exam, so you need to know latest updates in pathology and laboratory. Yes, we have more changes here. And also in medicine section, we have 43 additions, 12 revisions and there are no deletions. In category 3, usually F series course, we have 82 additions, 13 revisions and 32 deletions. And in administrative multi-analyte analysis with algorithmic analysis, we have 1 addition, 0 revision and 1 deletion. So in this session, we are going to learn from 10,000 to 69,979. So in future sessions, I will create one video for evaluation management, which is having one edition, 10 revisions and 0 deletions. So if you check in the bottom, we have total 230 editions, 70 revisions and 49 deletions. Overall, these are spread in complete CPT book. So now we will learn about musculoskeletal system changes. So here, as we have discussed previously, we have 4 editions, 6 revisions and no deletions. So now initially we will learn 4 editions. So we have 22836 and 22837 and 22838. 22836. What is this? Anterior thoracic vertebral body tethering, including thoracoscopy when performed up to 7 vertebral segment, and 37 is for 8 or more vertebral segment. So in order to understand this one, we need to know what is vertebral body tethering. Basically, this vertebral body tethering is the procedure which is usually performed for scoliosis, or usually we will call it as idiopathic scoliosis in the growing children. Usually, physician will place bracing and try to reduce the scoliosis. But some children, this scoliosis is very severe and these braces will not work. In this vertebral body tethering, physician will use anchors and flexible cord in order to reduce the abnormal curvature of the spine. Usually in tethering, physician will place anchors on the outward curvature of the spine, and also physician will place tether, and this tether is attached to the anchors and placed spine in the tension. Over time, as the child continues to grow, the spine lengthens, the tether slows the growth on the curved side of the spine. So these anchors and tether will be permanently attached to the patient's spine. In order to perform this procedure, initially physician will create few incisions. So in this spine, in this image, physician created incisions, and using these incisions, physician will place screws inside the outer curvature of the spine. After placing these screws, physician will insert the flexible cord. As the patient grows, the spine will get strength and it will get straight. So this is simple. Physician will place these incisions on the curvature side of the spine, and after placing this incision, physician will place the screws. Along with these screws, physician will threaded flexible cord. So here 36 and 37 for based on number of vertebrae, and here thoracoscopy is also included. So 36 is for up to 7 vertebral segment, and 37 is for 8 or more vertebral segment, and we have 22838. This is for revision. So revision, replacement or removal of thoracic vertebral body tethering, including thoracoscopy when performed. So 36 and 37 for implantation of the tethering or tethering procedure, and 38 is for revision or replacement or removal of thoracic vertebral body tethering. So here we need to remember thoracoscopy is included. We no need to code thoracoscopy using these 3 codes. Next, we have 27278. So arthrodesis, sacroiliac joint percutaneous with image guidance, including placement of intra-articular components, example bone graft synthetic device without placement of transfixation device. So basically we have 27279. There we have physician will use placement of transfixation device. But in 2024, we have 27278, where physician will place intra-articular implants including bone graft and synthetic device, but he will not fix any transfixation device. So these are the common bone allografts physician will use in order to fuse sacroiliac joint. So next we have revisions in balanectomy procedure. These are not major revisions, but these are minor revisions only. So previously we have bracket in the balanectomy, but now the AMA deleted these brackets here, and they have included width. Instead of brackets, they have included width. So all these codes, they have removed the brackets and they have included the width. So here also, so 2023, we have 28297 correction hallux valgus balanectomy in the bracket with sesamoidectomy when performed with first metatarsal and medial cuneiform joint arthrodesis any method. So in 2024, we have same code. If you check the description, correction hallux valgus with balanectomy with sesamoidectomy when performed with first metatarsal and medial cuneiform joint arthrodesis any method. So just there is only small change where instead of brackets in 2024 we will see with word for all these balanectomy codes. So usually these are the bunions. So bunions will come at metatarsophalangeal joint. Usually we will call it as MTP. So this is the metatarsal and this is the phalangeal joint. So whenever there is a bunion, this MTP joint will be unaligned and patient will get bunion. So if anyone asks what is bunion, so we can tell that abnormal angulation of metatarsophalangeal joint. Now we will check respiratory system. So we have only two editions. So there are no revisions, there are no deleted codes. So if we see here, we have two editions. First one is 31242, second one is 31243. So nasal sinus endoscopy, surgical with destruction by radio frequency ablation, posterior nasal nerve, and 243 is for nasal sinus endoscopy, surgical with destruction by cryoablation, posterior nasal nerve. So basically, this is the procedure. This is the nasal nerve here. Physician will use radio frequency ablation or cryoablation. So both are same, comes under destruction. The technique is different here. So in 242, physician will use radio frequency, and in 243, physician will use cryoablation. So next we have cardiovascular phrenic nerve simulation system. So we have 8 codes added, no revisions and no deleted codes from cardiovascular system. So if you check here, this is the phrenic nerve location, and in order to treat hypoventilation and high quadriplegia, physician will use these phrenic nerve stimulators. So if you check the first code 33276, insertion of phrenic nerve stimulator system, which includes pulse generator and stimulating lead, including vessel catheterization, all imaging guidance, and pulse generator initial analysis with diagnostic mode activation when performed. So whenever we have phrenic nerve stimulator system coding, we no need to code vessel catheterization and any type of imaging guidance and pulse generator initial analysis, which is for diagnostic mode activation. So we have 33277, insertion of phrenic nerve stimulator transfer sensing lead. So this is 277 is for only lead insertion. So basically 33278 is opposite of 33276. Basically 33276, insertion of phrenic nerve stimulator system, but in 33278, removal of phrenic nerve stimulator system. So if we check in 33278, physician will remove pulse generator and lead. If you check 33279, physician will remove transvenous stimulation or sensing lead only. So just you need to understand that we have separate codes for lead insertion and lead removal. So 33277 for lead insertion, 33279 for lead removal. So previously we learned 33279 for lead removal. So 33280 is for pulse generator removal only. And we have 33281, which is for repositioning of the phrenic nerve stimulator transvenous lead. and 33287 is for replacement of phrenic nerve stimulator, including vessel catheterization, all imaging guidance, and interrogation and programming when performed. So this is only for pulse generator replacement. 33288 for replacement of transvenous stimulation or sensing leads. So now we will learn genitourinary and female genital system. So we have two new codes added from genitourinary 1 and female genital system 1. So there are no revised codes and there are no deleted codes. So in genitourinary system, we have one code added here, which is 52284, cystourethroscopy with mechanical urethral dilation and urethral therapeutic drug delivery by drug-coated balloon catheter for urethral stricture or stenosis, male including fluoroscopy when performed. So basically, so this is the cystoscope into the urethra, this is the prostate, this is the bladder. So here physician will insert drug-coated balloon for in order to treat urethral stricture or stenosis. So whenever you find the documentation, and also if the patient is male patient who is having urethral stricture or stenosis, if the physician is going to do mechanical urethral dilation as well as drug delivery by drug-coated balloon catheter, we need to use 52284. So you need to remember this code is for only male patients. So in female genital system, we have only one code, so which is 58580, transcervical ablation of the uterine fibroid. So if you check here, so they have mentioned S in the bracket. So if it is single fibroid or multiple fibroids, we need to use same code, including intraoperative ultrasound guidance and monitoring radio frequency. So basically, using the ultrasound guidance and using the radio frequency, physician will ablate the or distract the fibroids in the uterus. So if you check nervous system, we have 6 additions, 4 revisions, and there are no deletions. So we will start with 61889, insertion of skull-mounted cranial neurostimulator pulse generator or receiver, including craniectomy or craniotomy when performed with direct or inductive coupling with connection to deep and or cortical strip electrode array. So basically this is for cranial neurostimulator. As we need to know that we have 3 types of neurostimulators in CPT coding. First one is cranial stimulator, next one is spinal stimulator, and last one is peripheral stimulator. So these added codes are for cranial neurostimulator. So this is the brain, so this is the neurostimulator. So 61889 for insertion of cranial neurostimulator, and 6189 is for revision or replacement of cranial neurostimulator, and 61892 for removal of skull mounted cranial neurostimulator. So 64596 is for insertion or replacement of percutaneous electrode array peripheral nerve with integrated neurostimulator including imaging guidance when performed initial electrode array. 64595 is for insertion or replacement of percutaneous electrode array, but this is for peripheral nerve. So these are for intracranial nerves, so these are for peripheral nerves. As we have discussed, we have in CPT 3 types of neurostimulator: cranial stimulator and peripheral neurostimulator and spinal neurostimulator. Now 6459697908 for peripheral nerve neurostimulators. So if we check, we here 64596, insertion or replacement of percutaneous electrode array peripheral nerve with integrated neurostimulator including imaging guidance when performed initial electrode array, and 64597 is for each additional electrode array. So we need to use 64597 only with 64596, and we have 64598, revision or removal of neurostimulator electrode array peripheral nerve with integrated neurostimulator. So this is for revision or removal. So 64596 is for insertion or replacement, 64598 for revision or removal of neurostimulator electrode array. So as we have discussed, we have 4 revisions in nervous system. So in 2023, we have 63385. So everything is normal here. Just in 636.85 in 2024, they have added requiring pocket creation and connection between electrode array and pulse generator or receiver. And 88, they have added with detachable connection to electrode array. In 90, they have added same wording which we have seen in the 636.85. And 645.95, they have added here sacral. So if you see here, revision or remola, peripheral or gastric neurostimulator, pulse generator or receiver. If you check in 2024, same 645.95, revision or remola, peripheral, sacral or gastric neurostimulator, pulse generator or receiver with detachable connection to electrode array. So just there is addition of or revision of the code descriptions here. So if you check all these blue markings, so you can understand easily. So next, we have I and Eckler Edinexa. We have one code added in I and Eckler Edinexa. So there are no revisions, there are no deletions. So added code is 667516, suprachoroidal space injection of pharmacological agents. This is a separate procedure. So this is the suprachoroidal space. Here, physician will use pharmacological agent. Thank you guys. So if you like this session, please like, comment, share and subscribe passcode 21. So if you have any suggestions you want to forward to us, please send to vincentmedicalcoder@gmail.com. Thank you. Please like and comment, which will motivate me to provide more valuable medical coding sessions, which are helpful for each and everyone, including all specialties.